In this video, we're going to take a look at a few ways to help mix our audio clips in the timeline. So as previously discussed, we can simply select any particular audio clip and drag it around, and we can use the handles to help trim out any unwanted or unused pieces of audio that we may not want by dragging them around like that. But we can also copy and paste audio clips to help build up effects. So in this case, so he's got his attack going on. Let's maybe just copy this. Let's try and maybe make this effect a little bit more, have a little more oomph to it. So let's copy this effect and paste it into a new track. So first, let's create a new track by right-clicking. I'm going to go to New Audio Track. And let's move it up one by right-clicking and move track up. So now they're underneath of each other. I will select my attack and then just select my new track I just made and paste it. And I just pasted the sound effect, and I'm going to offset it just a little bit just to give it a little bit maybe of some reverb or echo to it as it kind of travels through space there. So let's hit play. So now it's got a little bit of echo to it, a little more oomph to it. But we can also change the way the volume affects our clips. So we can right click anywhere within our audio tracks, and we want to go to Show Volume. And now you'll notice some controls have just appeared, and we can add a control to these clips by holding down the Alt key. You'll see a little plus appears next to our cursor, and by holding down Alt and clicking, it adds a point. And if I click it again, it disappears. You'll see a little subtract appear. So that's how we add and remove points. So maybe what I'll do is I'll add a few points here. I'll give it a little bit of a boost at the crescendo, and then I'll add a third one at the end and kind of fade it out a bit as it disappears. So let's play it back and hear how that sounds. So now we have a little bit of building to it. But maybe I want to kind of fine-tune things a little bit more. I want to be able to fine-tune where I adjust my audio or even within the picture itself, see how things sync up. So we can also do that with our ears, but we can also right-click and go to Show Waveform. And now we have a good visual cue of where things are happening within our audio clip. So I'm gonna move this actually over a little bit to where it builds a little more, like so. That feels a little better, and if I hit play, it just builds up a bit more and has a bit more heaviness to it. So one final thing we can also do to our audio clips is we can split them if we need to within a track. So if we need to copy and paste, and if we need to split them in a location according to time, for example, we can just right click. We've set our time marker to where we want to make our cut. We can right click and we can go to split the clip at current frame, and now I just cut this audio clip into two. I can click and drag it. Now I have two of them within the same track, and for me to do with what I please with. And I can still extend the length of it if I need to add a little more time into it for whatever reason we want to mix it in there a little bit more. And so those are some of the ways we can mix audio inside the timeline of Storyboard Pro.